Well, it was another disappointing day in the stock market that had all the pieces to actually be a great session at the start, right? Apple, well, it did hold up. They had that strong earnings report. And also healthcare was pretty good, led by hospitals, looked great. But that was about it, right? There are a lot of issues weighing on this market. The Fed now talking about, quote, symmetric inflation. What the heck does that mean? Then there's the dollar surging through its 200-day moving average. But in a way, that was long overdue. Still, the dollar is miles away from its all-time high, but spooking investors. And then there's earning results on fire. But the narrative has been and continues to be that this is as good as it gets. And it has many investors thinking that this is the top. Consequently, they're sending stocks substantially lower. Now, the question is this a rational market or a market that's, to a degree, a victim of its own success and probably simply overdue for these wild moves? Joining me now to discuss, Shaw Galani, editor of the Capital Wave Forecast, and Melissa Armo, the stock Swoosh. All right, Shaw, what's going on?
I think the expectations are so high, so baked in to the market that anything that's disappointing is going to bring the whole market down.
But there's not earnings, some of these things aren't disappointing.
No, nothing,
though.
But nothing has been disappointing. Earnings have been fabulous. I think, you know, look at the FANG stocks, ones that report so far. Average revenue is up 28%. So terrific stuff. However, the narrative is interest rates are on the rise, the dollar is rising. That means that the multinationals that export in terms of translation of their earnings back into dollars, that's going to cost them money. And so we got this dark cloud hanging over it. But fundamentally, everything is sound. It's just a narrative we have to get past.
When I do my analytical work, I do it in constant currency. So I take out the noise of currency. I can't believe that seasoned investors would be acting this way to a long overdue move in a dollar. Is that it, Melissa, or are there more things going on here?
Well, the market's definitely reacting technically different than what the fundamentals are saying, just like you said. Ultimately, we're just not seeing enough buying coming into the market, and it takes a lot of money to move stocks up, and it's not coming in. It's just not coming in. We're in a period where we're either going to rest in this range or we're going to break. And I'm going to give you some very specific levels. In the Dow, it's 23,300. If we break that level, it's right on the 200-day moving
average. If we go underneath that number.
If we break that at all, we...
Thar she blows.
Panic City, USA. Right. We are closer to doing that than we are to making new highs. We're only $5 away from that. We're down in the after hours.
Well, since you brought
tonight.
Up technicals, do you give any credit to the fact that we have held at some key points over this sort of range that we've been in?
I will tell you, the fact that we keep retesting it is not good. You're right, we held, but we 8 times we've gone down there. Why? No. That isn't good. You go down, boom, it's going to break it. And that's what I'm saying. You're going to see a wave of selling.
In technical terms also, the market has made lower highs. Every time it has gone down, it's tried to make another high, it's been a little lower. It's tried to make another high, it's a little lower. Tried to make another high, it's a little lower. So that is a very bearish trend.
How does the market break out of it? I mean, if the catalyst isn't strong earnings and pretty positive guidance, if the catalyst isn't technology stocks doing well, like before, at least they had coattails, what's the catalyst here that gets this market through this, breaking through that series of lower highs?
A brilliant question. I think the short answer is I don't think there isn't a catalyst, because we've had plenty of catalysts. The market has not been able to get above any of them. So I think the problem we're going to face right now is we're going to see some kind of flushing action. I think that's going to be probably pretty ugly. That's going to be the buying point.
Is that what we need, a capitulation?
I don't think we need it, but it looks like we're, like I said last week, I think we're not going to make new highs this summer. I think the market's going to digest the huge, massive rally that it had in 2017. It's not bad. The main thing I want people to know is do not panic. If you are retired right now, or you're going to retire in the next 12 months, if we break that level I said, you might want to sell or move your money into something else. If you're in it for the long haul, stay the course. If you're not retired in the next 12 months, because we're going to hold the uptrend. Even when we break, we're so far from going in a downtrend. And most of the time, the life of the market is in an uptrend, because a lot of money in the market is retirement accounts, and they go long.
Sure. What ultimately then, if we can't turn this around here, when do fundamentals matter again? And could it be a blessing in disguise that there's so much anxiety of this being as good as it gets? Because let's not forget, what propelled Apple's shares was the fact that Wall Street was so negative on it to begin with.
I think the fundamentals are absolutely fabulous. I think they're going to get even better than they are. So we've got a little bit of a blip here, and I think that problem is all mechanical. It's technical, it's mechanical. I think the downside we could see is going to be short-lived. I think if we get a big downside move, that is going to be a tremendous buying opportunity.
Quickly, guys, geopolitical risk and Washington, D.C. risk. Seems like every time there's a change in President Trump's legal team, that puts some pressure on the market. Also, the North Korea summit, not financial, directly financial news, but could resolution in those things help the market?
Exactly. I was just going to say that earlier before you said this. You were looking for a catalyst. There you go.
All right. Thank you both very, very much. Appreciate it. Outrage online over a dress that a teenager wore to her prom. Many on the left are calling it racist. Whatever happened to the melting pot? We'll discuss it next.
This market check is brought to you by Schwab Trading Services. Own your tomorrow.